Hi, thanks for stopping by and welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to evaluate PDF performance on Kobo Libra H2O. This is going to be our agenda for today. We will use the PDF shown in the right hand side. I chose this PDF as it has images and colored text. I thought this will be a good reference file. We will also convert PDF to EPUB using Calibre software to see how that looks and performs. In the end, we will draw a conclusion. So let's get started, shall we? Okay, so I have already copied the PDF file to my Kobo Libra device. You can see here it is 12.7 MB. And let's go ahead and start open this file. Okay, let's try it again. Yeah, there you go. So the initial look and feel from the original PDF looks similar. Of course, the color looks dim, but the format is maintained and the swipe performance along with the images also seems to be fine. So there's no problem. However, if you swipe it from the top, it's a bit tricky in PDF because when you try to swipe it, it goes to the front or back page. So you can see here, there is no option for the font, which means that you cannot increase the size of the font as well as you cannot increase the line spacing. This is going to be a problem for PDF file like this where the original text itself is very small, so you cannot read it. So to solve the problem, you will pinch and zoom like this so that the readability is increased. However, the problem with this approach is that you can read it, but you need to keep panning on the left and right side of the screen depending on which part of the screen you want to read it. And this is not practical because nobody can read with this method. Even though it is smooth, it is definitely not practical. So you can see if you really want to read it for a smaller text, then this is the only option. And swipe will not help, so you have to use the button, and every page that you would go to, it will be in the zoomed state, as you can see here. And now this is a state where it is sort of hung. So I had seen this earlier also with a zoom percentage of somewhere 300 and 350 as well. It's no longer responding. So you can see if I touch screen, pinch zoom, it's not working. Try to pan it, it's not working. Right, if I try to press the button, same thing, it's not going backward or forward. Try to slide it, nope, no options working. Back to the home page, no. So at this stage, it is safe to say that the device is in a hung state. I have seen this second time during my test before I was recording this video. So it does look like when you zoom it to a certain percentage and if you have images, then it will go out of memory and then it goes into a state where it no longer responds. So the only option you have is to bounce the device. See, it's completely hung, so it's completely unusable. So the device actually crashed. I was about to restart it, but it actually crashed. So it looks like the memory was completely consumed. So it's back again. Let's go to my books and open the file again. Somehow this PDF file does not open in one touch. Let's try it again. Again. Okay, so it's open. Alright, so other thing that I want to mention with the PDF file is that you cannot highlight the section like you normally do. Also, you cannot look up for a word in dictionary or in Wikipedia. So that would be a limitation as well. Now let's convert the PDF file to EPUB and let's see how that performs. So I'm going to use Calibre software for this. You can download it free. And then you load the PDF file to the program and then you click on convert books In this page, you can see the input format is PDF, and output format you want to select EPUB. There are other formats available, but we'll select EPUB for Kobo. Under look and feel font, I'm going to select this option. I don't want it to change it. And the text section, leave it as it is. Layout, leave it as it is. Styling, as well as the transformation styles, no need to change it. In heuristic processing also, there is nothing to be changed. Under structure detection, if you want, you can change the XPath. It's a bit complicated. There is a documentation in Calibre's website, but let's leave it like that. And let's go ahead and convert it. So it is going to take some time, so I'm going to pause the video and then we'll resume. Okay, so we are done. Now let's send this file to the device. So you need to click on the file and then you click on send to device. And then it will be transferred to the device. And then let's go ahead and eject the device. Okay, done. Once it is transferred, you will see the device. The name will be same, but the format you can see as EPUB. So let's go ahead and open it. So the front page looks fine, but as you move along, you will see all the images are already gone. So you can see these images are gone. It's no longer there. The text part looks okay to a certain extent, and you have all of your options as well, which were originally missing in PDF format. But then there's a compromise of these images, which I believe is a fault of conversion. There could be some better program which can do better conversion, but Calibre, this is the best it has done. And if as you move along, you will also notice this. If you can see here, the words are all jumbled up, so it's kind of scrambled. So it looks like that in the text department also, the conversion does not do a good job. So even though the readability and options have increased, but overall the PDF file has been compromised. So most of the images are gone. Even the text are not in the right state. So overall, I would say it's not worth it. As you can see here, it's definitely bad. You cannot read it. It does not make any sense, most of the things. And it looks like most of the images are actually gone, except for this one. But most of the images are gone. So overall, I would say if you convert the file from PDF to EPUB, then it's not going to be good. However, it also depends on what file you're converting and what's the structure of that file, and accordingly, it might do a good job. All right, to conclude, we can say that the PDF files can be handled, but readability can be an issue depending on the original font size, which means that if the PDF file has a good font size, then you will not see any issue once you transfer the file to Kobo. PDF with images has a potential to deplete the memory, especially if you zoom it and read it. I have not seen any issue if you read it as it is. PDF files also does not give you the option to change font size and line spacing, and it also does not give you the option for dictionary and Wikipedia search. Converting to EPUB is not recommended unless the PDF is text only with no images. However, there could be a better paid software than Calibre which may do a good job overall. So this concludes our video. I hope you find it informational and you liked it. If you would like to support my channel, then please consider subscribing to it so that I can make more videos like this in the future. and I would like to thank you for your time. Goodbye and stay safe.